Now Barack Obama may be cutting his vacation short. The president could return to Washington as soon as Wednesday to restart talks on avoiding the fiscal cliff. Talks between Obama and U.S. House Speaker John Boehner broke off before Christmas. With the latest on the fiscal cliff negotiations, we are joined by our Washington Bureau Chief, Bryn Weiss, right here in Toronto. So, Bryn, what's the latest? He's saying aloha to Hawaii.
Well, that's right, Kathy. As you mentioned, President Barack Obama could be in Washington later tonight or early tomorrow if he turns Air Force One into a red-eye flight out of Hawaii. And this is all, of course, to speed up or reignite talks to avert the fiscal cliff. Reports indicate that Obama's staff have been working, actually, with the aides of congressional Democrats to try to craft together a deal that they think they might be able to get enough support from Republicans in Congress to avert the fiscal cliff. As you know, now we have 5 days before the end of the year when all of these tax hikes and spending cuts really start to come into effect. And economists have warned this could send the U.S. back into another recession. If we remember where we were on Friday of last week when the talks broke off and everyone cleared out of Washington for the Christmas break, John Boehner had just pulled vote on his plan B. This would have been a Republican vote in the House of Representatives to extend the tax cuts for everyone except millionaires. But it appeared there wasn't enough Republican support for that plan, which was proposed by House Speaker Republican John Boehner. And so that vote was canceled. Republicans called off the rest of the session, went home for the holidays, and promised to reconvene on Thursday, tomorrow. So we'll see if there's been any movement from the Republican front. Also on the Democrat side, President Barack Obama, really the most, the latest Democrat offer, Kathy, was that Obama would concede tax hikes for $400,000 incomes or more, and they were hoping that was maybe a good enough compromise to get support from Republicans. It wasn't, so we are still at quite a stalemate here, but talks should resume either late tonight or tomorrow, and lawmakers, you can bet, are keen to get to some sort of solution to avert the fiscal cliff. In other news, Starbucks in the Washington, D.C. area are going to start writing "come together" on customers' cups, trying to convince lawmakers who might be buying a latte in the mornings to compromise and come to a deal. This is the first time Starbucks has ever written anything on cups as part of a campaign. And a letter from the CEO of Starbucks earlier today when they announced the campaign, or rather earlier this week, says that this is an effort to bring people together in not only the holiday tradition, but also the Starbucks tradition of bringing people together around a warm cup of coffee.
No kidding. Well, if it's going to work, something's got to give, right?
Well, that's right. If it works, good for them. Yeah. Something's got to do it.
Okay, thanks, Bryn.
Thanks, Kathy.
That was Bryn Weiss in our Toronto newsroom.